everyone said it was impossible, that it couldn't be done, but I figured it out, how you can set your main Windows drive not just as C, but as any other drive letter, even A. Now, should you do this? Probably not. I'll explain why. This is more of just a fun educational video to show you what's possible. But if you are maybe a rebel, you can actually do it yourself. Admittedly, I'm definitely not the first person to ever figure this out, but I could not find anyone who's ever posted any kind of detailed instructions online about how to actually achieve it. The closest thing I could find to instructions online was some forum thread where one guy described the broad steps he used. He basically said you have to change the drive letter between when you install Windows and run the first time setup, and then Windows will do everything in the background using that letter. Except for the most important part, the only instruction he gave was set the letter.
Bruh.
Not exactly a tutorial, but I was able to figure it out, and it's actually not that hard once you know what to do, and it only takes a couple of extra minutes versus the normal installation process. However, one very important thing to note is that you can only do this method when you are initially installing Windows with a clean installation. If you tried to do this with your current installation of Windows, it would break everything because it's already set up and installed with a bunch of programs referencing the C drive. Everything would break. Anyway, let's go over to the computer and I'll show you exactly how to do it. I'll just do it on a virtual machine. All right, so the first step is we need to do a clean install of Windows. I'm going to assume you know how to get to this point where you created the installation media and you've now booted to it. So we can just click install now, go through all this. And again, I'm not gonna spend too much time on this. I'm just gonna skip through it. You should probably already know how to do this. It's the normal installation, clean install, you create a new partition, everything normal. All right, now once you get to this point where it says it needs to restart to continue, we don't want to do that. So instead, we are going to simply turn off the computer before it restarts because we don't want it to do the initial setup. We need to do some stuff between then. So at this point, make sure that you're going to be booting from the installation media again. So you might have to look in the BIOS, make sure the disk drive or USB is set to boot first or manually boot to it. Because if it does start the initial Windows setup, you have to start over. And now we will be back to the Windows setup screen. Next, we want to bring up the command prompt by pressing Shift F10. And again, do not do any of this on your current Windows installation. It will not work. Anyway, the first thing we're going to do is type in regedit to open the registry editor. Then we need to load the Hive on the actual drive. So right now, this is not the actual registry on the Windows drive. It's actually the one on the installation media. So instead, we're going to click H key local machine. You have to click and have this highlighted. Then we're going to go file and load Hive. If you don't have this clicked and highlighted, this won't show up. So do that. And then we need to navigate to the Windows directory, system32, config, system, and then open that. And you can call it anything. Let's just call it local disk. Then we can click in this. And this is the actual registry on the drive that we are modifying that's going to be used with Windows. And what we're looking for is this mounted devices key. And then where it says DOS devices C, we're going to rename that and just change it to A. And now we can close out of this. Next, we're going to type in disk part. We're going to list all the volumes. So list volume. And we can see that the C drive is on volume one. So we are going to select volume one or whatever number it is. We're going to type remove, which is going to remove the drive letter. And now we're going to assign letter equals whatever letter you want. I'll do A. So it's successfully assigned. Then we type exit. Now we need to edit the boot record. So what we're going to do is type BCD edit. And now here you may or may not see this has already changed. If it says C, there are two commands you're going to need to change. But if it already says A, you should be good. Or if it doesn't work, maybe try this anyway. But we're going to use the following two commands. One is bcdedit/set, and then we're going to do default in brackets, device partition equals A colon. Says success. And then we're going to do the same exact one, except we're going to change this to OS device. And that is going to change this if it needed to be. But we're just going to do it for demonstration. And it says successfully again. And then we can just type it in. If before it didn't say A, it does now. Then you can just shut down the computer, take out the installation media, run it, and this will continue the Windows setup, but using the A drive. And we can actually test that right now. If we press Shift F10 already, we can see that the A drive is used as
the path for Windows. So it already worked. We don't have to actually wait to see if it worked, but we may as well see the results, so I'll speed through this. All right, so we are in Windows, finished setting up, and now we can go to this PC and see that A is the main drive with Windows installed on it. We can go to A, Windows, and it's all in here. So it worked. And yeah, that's all there is to it.
Now, like I said, there are some reasons why you might not want to do this. It will work, and you shouldn't have any issues with Windows itself, but from experience, you might come across occasional programs that don't like this situation. And I can actually speak from experience because many years ago on Windows Vista, I somehow accidentally installed Windows onto the D drive as a D letter and just used it for a while. And I think the main problem you would come across, which is the one I did, is occasional programs that are hard-coded in some way to assume the C drive. So not Windows itself being the problem, but programs. For example, I can't remember exactly what the program was, but at some point, I was trying to install a program that didn't let me change the installation path, and it was requiring that I install to the C drive, which was not my main drive, so I don't think I was able to even install that. Besides the possible installation issues, some programs might just be weird about it having an A and B drive in general. For example, Adobe Lightroom does not actually support the A and B drives. If you go to try and import stuff, it's not one of the options unless you do like a workaround. So I guess if you're willing to deal with a couple issues every once in a while in exchange for the cool factor, it might be worth it to you. I guess that's all I have to say. If you guys enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a big giant thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make a couple videos, usually Wednesday and Saturday. If you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is one I made a while ago talking about what happened to the A and B drives. And I also go into a lot more detail about how mounting works on various operating systems. I think you'll actually find it pretty interesting. So you can click on that right there. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.